Hi, everyone. So we are releasing very soon the next version of MuleChain AI Connector, version 0.2.0. So you can see we have done some few changes here. That's why we have a section here for the current version, which is 0.1.0, where we are talking about how to get started and what are the supported methods. So you can use this documentation, I think, for the next 3 months. After that, we will remove it. We changed some things in the connector itself. So from the getting started, if I would start from here, we added support for Java 17 and 11. Also, what we did is we have changed the way to configure it. So now you can see we have moved the model name, temperature, timeout, and max token we have added, also next to temperature. So the model name which you used in the previous release is now moved to the configuration side along temperature, timeout, and max token. And temperature and timeout are very nice parameters to govern and control the model. So here in the configuration, we are describing how to use these configuration parameters. Also, one nice thing, what is now available is that based on the selection of the LLM type, you will only see the models which are relating to that specific LLM. And here, thanks to our engineering colleagues, Dipesh and Arpit, who did all the code cleaning here. So regarding the additional parameters we have added is the temperature, where you can control the LLM in terms of random answers. So you have here the possibility to add a value between 0 to 2. And 0.9 is the average, where you can have it medium configured. It can also come up with some innovative random answers, but that's the default value what we have. Also, the max token is the way to control in terms of what is the maximum token the LLM should consume in terms of providing the answer. And we are going to see additional capabilities on the operations for this specific token usage. So let's go to the operations and see what has changed there. Not much in terms of the fields are the same. The only thing which changed now is we moved the different models to the configuration. I think if I would go across those, or let me show you actually what we have added. So we have added here some additional input, how to make it a JSON, because the output of the operation, of every operation, is a string. So you convert it here to JSON, and that's basically the JSON where you have token usage, output count, total count, and input count for the token. So you have a better understanding how much has been processed. So let me walk you through all these different operations to see if there is any major thing we need to discuss. This is still chat answer prompt with memory. It remains the same. We are just highlighting additional values. So in the previous release, we just replied with the response. Now you have additional controlling parameters. On the embedding itself, I think we added additional operations. So here on the add document to store, that remains, but we have added add folder to store. So it will take all folders and subfolders of a defined path and ingest all the files of a specific type, which you can also control from outside, as this is a possible data weave function field here. So this is something we have added, so you can load all your documents into one folder and from there build it into a knowledge store. Here we are also providing some information on the embedding itself. The query is the next one we have added on the in-memory vector store, which you can now define. Okay, what is here? The store name, of course, the question, the max result of document to be considered in order to provide a final feedback, and the minimum score. This is something we have added. And on some of those, you will find also the get latest one. As the in-memory concept is on file base, so with the get latest to true, you basically load the latest file actually. And here our recommendation is to keep it on false. Only set it to true in testing purposes or when you are building the knowledge store. But we will look into it in more detail. And also in terms of the output, this is something where we will also provide additional references to the documents. It's already provided. I have to update here the documentation, but in the demo, we will see it, what it means, what is the result here from the output. This stays the same, basically, here, the get info from store, but we have here some additional information which we are providing in terms of absolute part, file name, text segment, which is used from the sources to articulate the answer from the LLM. Along those token usage, again, new store stays the same, one-to-one. And we have, that's it, actually. And I guess, yeah, let's go to image. I think here is also similar. What we change actually is also here. Here we are providing now an object. So if you want to get the image URL for the image generation operation, then this is the syntax we are providing here. So you can get the URL as output. We have reg here. I think we didn't add anything except, no, that's it. Yeah, we didn't add anything. For the sentiment analyzer, yeah, again, the output token, and for the tools as well, you have the output token, which is pretty much defined and also shows you when tools are used or not. This might be very useful for you to take alternative passes in any point. But now let me go to the demo. So this is our example app. My testing app. Let me show you the configuration so you get a little bit of feeling how it is appearing now. So you can see this is the way it's configured. You have the model name, temperature, timeout, and max token here in the configuration tab. We have the same here, but for a different model. So you can see here's a different model defined. You can also go here and do kind of data weave expression if you want. And temperature is different. You have here the max token defined. So that's basically the configuration we have added here. And the operations are more or less the same. So that looks pretty much the same. So let me now go operation by operation and we will execute it. The app is already started. So this is the prompt template. Let's go here into the agent and prompt template. I'll just fire this request. So the first time you will see it takes a little bit longer because here the model is initialized, but the follow-up requests for the same model are faster. If I'm switching between Mistral and OpenAI, of course, the first call will take a little bit. So what you see, the response, the token usage is provided here. So it's very powerful. The answer is, yeah. It's the answer what we have defined in the prompt template. I won't be diving in detail into this one. Let's take a look on the chat. I think this is now Mistral, so it will still take a little bit. What is the capital of Switzerland? Land, it should come up with. It's Bern. That along the tokens itself. Taking longer than expected, but my machine is also heating up. Might be a local thing or a key is expired. Okay, so at least it came back. So it is now, yeah, here I have it. The next one, I'm not sure. I think this again, Mistral. If I would fire it, you will see it's much faster now. It's initialized and you can see that. Value, the output is fine. Also, the way we are exposing the parameters in the output has changed. And that's really due to the, transform message afterwards. So that's what makes the whole string coming out here a JSON. So you can see a chat, we have seen chat prompt with memory, we have seen. So we are exposing these parameters also to the outside. And now let's come to the embeddings. And here we have some very nice changes. So let's close this one. We go to new store. So the new store is now created. And the first thing I can do is just straightforward query it, you can see I don't get any information. This is the query method we added to simply query the in-memory embedding store without the involvement of the LLM. And that's important in some cases if you don't want to pass, use the get info operation. You can use this one to get just the data out and maybe use a prompt template to do your own thing. That's actually the embedding query parameter, which has the maximum number of documents to use, the minimum score, and as well here, the get latest one. As I'm ingesting and querying, I think that's the good parameter, but normally you would first create the whole embedding store, deploy it, and then you set this to off and deploy another app with this query or get info, which is then polling that specific deployed embedding store. So now let's see what happens if I add something. So we have your add document to store. So a new store is created, add document to store. Now this time it will be new chain. It's a text file which includes a lot of information from AWS Reg and a little bit about MuleChain. So let's ask here, what is MuleChain? And we will get the answer back. You see it's super fast because no LLM is involved. It's just a query store. So we get the absolute information, the sources, of course, the absolute information, individual score, how this has been rated based on my question. And that's actually it. There's no more embeddings. But let's add another one, which is now text, this example fake product description. I will add it. It will be added quickly. And now I can query the same. And you will see this was the last answer, which has only one embedding result. But if I fire it again, based on the similarity search, we now receive two segments. And you can see this is the highest score. However, there is a second one, which includes the just ingested file, and it is above 70. So 72, that makes it appear here. So now let's add another one, which is through the URL. So this URL will be added. It's more information on MuleChain project. And if I query now, what is MuleChain? You will see we get a text segment, and this time the reference is to the URL. So you exactly know from where it is getting those information, individual scoring. You see here the absolute path. Again, the scoring, this time it's a file. So these kind of things we have added, which makes it more concrete and trustable in terms of for using it for your users or customers. So let's continue. What else we have? We have here add folder. That's a good one. Let me show you how it works. So we define a folder to be added. Here you can see there is an add folder. I have this path. So I can go quickly to that path and show you what is inside. So here is the path. It's nothing but few ADOX files exported from our help page. Now we can import those. It should be quickly. So six files imported. And now I can again query the store and ask what is Cloud Hub HA. And it should come up here with few chunks with the scoring as well, with the file references. So you can see here three scoring all above 70% and the full response of all the text collected. I can take this now to, let's go here and say Cloud Hub HA. It should be sending the same response to the LLM. This full response or information is sent to the LLM, which is then replying actually in natural language along the sources, what we see here. It is replying here in a natural language with the tokens which we used. So that's basically the improvements we have on the embedding side. I think these are some really nice features to get start using the embedding, in-memory embedding. Next one, image. I think this is something that we didn't change anything. So let me go now to, or let's go through this one as well. So image generation, what do we get? If I fire this, It will take some time, of course, but it will come up with a link which I can click and get the picture of whatever. It will be a dancing penguin on the beach, cartoon style. Here it is. I can fire it directly from Postman, so it should show me the penguin dancing on the beach. That's nice. Okay, working, my testing is fine. And also here I have bottles. So let me show you this one. This is the image read. We didn't change anything here, but again, if you are watching the first time, I know these are just the packages. So I'm asking a question, how many packages are there, given the smallest one is this, and the token volume of all together. So let's see what it replies. So it will need to read this URL, understand the picture, and come up with the answer. Yeah, it's okay. So here you can see the token usage, also fine. Let's go to the reg. So reg load document, what is this one? So image we have seen just now, reg load document. Here you can basically provide different parameters. Again, model is not available here. So what is it? I'm just extracting data from a specific file into JSON. Let's do that. It's extracted quite fast. And once this is there, we can process this, of course. It will also show up, actually, the different tokens which we use. You can see here also the token, the reference, file type, and so on. So that's about it here. We can continue. The next one will be then sentiment. Let me go to the sentiment. Also nothing special here. No, just the data, it will be rated or analyzed, and it should come up positive, negative, is true. Token usage, nothing special. So for the tools, we added just a small improvement. So you can see here, let's say, what is the capital of Germany? And it should reply Berlin, but you see tool use is false. So I'm the same, I can now say check inventory for new test zero. It should do the API call to my inventory system. If it recognizes and provide me with the inventory details and the total number. So that's the total number from my SAP system. I trust it. And now this time you see tools are used. So basically we have added really some nice capabilities on the MuleChain AI connector, which we are going to push soon to 0.2.0, and it will be available on our GitHub repository under the master branch. Currently, you don't see it. It's currently the version 0.1, but very soon we will push it to 0.2.0 and you will have access to it. That's it from my side. Have fun. Enjoy the MuleChain, newest version, MuleChain AI connector, and we will post more innovation on that project. Thanks a lot.